The Philippine Tourism Department plans to build more infrastructure for the sector should its proposed 2025 budget get a boost. During a budget hearing at the House of Representatives, several lawmakers called for an increase to the agency's 3.39 billion peso spending plan. They cite the tourism sector's contribution of 8.6% to the country's GDP in 2023. Tourism Chief Cristina Frasco admits international tourist arrivals dropped to 5.45 million last year from the pre-pandemic record high of 8.3 million. But she asserts there are other tourism performance metrics that have exceeded pre-pandemic levels.
Since the onset of the pandemic, global world tourism bodies and nations have expanded their view of measuring tourism performance to include, most importantly, visitor receipts, the money that goes into the coffers of the nation and the pockets of our local stakeholders, because this is what keeps the economy running.
A June report from Fitch Ratings revealed the Philippines had the slowest tourism recovery in the Asia Pacific. More Filipinos are concerned about finances at home. A study by TransUnion suggests 44% of 900 respondents fear their income won't be enough to cover their bills. That's slightly higher from the same period last year, with inflation, job security, and interest rates among top concerns affecting household finances. The financial strain is shown in the change in spending habits, as 47% admit they have cut back on leisure spending. Still, TransUnion maintains Filipinos still have a more positive view in the long run on spending. It said while households expect to spend more on bills, they also look to increase retail shopping. A heads up for motorists, it's now time to fit your vehicles with RFIDs and load up as regulators begin gearing up for cashless transactions at expressways. Johnson Manabat with a full story.
Motorists who have no RFID stickers or not enough load at toll gates will be fined starting August 31. That's as the Joint Memorandum Circular 2024-001 of the Toll Regulatory Board, Department of Transportation and Land Transportation Office takes effect at the end of the month. The memo calls for motorists to have an electronic toll collection device like an RFID tag and sufficient load in preparation for cashless transactions by October this year.
Ang pakay po nito is to have a smoother and a better flow of traffic dito sa mga ETC or RFID lanes natin sa mga expressways. At ang objective is to promote responsible use and ma-encourage ang proper use ng ating mga RFID subscribers na dumadaan sa ating mga expressways. Target po kasi namin na ipatupad na by October 31 yung ating cashless transaction.
According to TRB spokesperson Julius Corpus, by August 31, motorists with insufficient load balance will be prohibited from entering toll plazas and violators will be facing penalties depending on the gravity of violation.
Baka kadaan pa rin po siya, no? Pero kung meron pong ano doon, ang tinatawag na may marshal doon or mga deputized traffic enforcer doon, right there and then, i-issuehan po siya ng show cause order. At titignan po doon kung maaaring ano, na mabigyan siya at pagkakataon na i-refute yung kanyang violation. So pwede pa naman po, kaya lang he might be issued a citation ticket or yung SCO na tinatawag natin, show cause order.
The Automobile Association of the Philippines cites pros and cons on requiring motorists to get RFIDs.
Talagang may discrimination yun kasi hindi ka magpapapasok pag wala kang RFID, di ba? May discrimination talaga, pero kung tinanong naman yung objective nung ginagawa nila, eh talaga namang ikabubuti. Pangalawa, libre na nga yung RFID, kumuha na lang tayo. Diba? Yung kasus mo, pareho din naman eh. O, diba? Kung wala kang RFID, magbabayad ka ng toll, yun din ang bayad mo eh. So, libre naman eh.
The TRB says 91% of toll expressway users are already compliant and responsible electronic toll collection or ETC users. AAP President Joe Ferreria believes the remaining 9% of toll expressway users will be forced to use local roads if they decide not to use RFID. This will be the challenge for local government units, Ferreria said.
After a few days or a few weeks, gagaan yung trapiko sa loob, no? However, may negative 'yan. Ay, ibig sabihin nun, yung sinasabi nilang 9% na non-compliant, eh, bumabiyahe pa rin yun. Saan dadaan yun? Dadaan yan sa mga local roads. So therefore, itatambak mo ngayon lahat yung 9% na dami na yon sa local roads. Ang tanong na mabigat dyan is, handa ba yung local government, handa ba silang tanggapin yung dadagdag na dami ng sasakyan sa lugar nila?
But officials are confident implementing this order will result in faster traffic flow in expressways. It promised to have a widespread information campaign before the end of the month. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.